When I logged into Sierra and I did some calculations, it made me realize that all of the research I'd done in the years for my PhD thesis and all of the computing that went into that, that could have been accomplished in less than a day with our Sierra supercomputer.
The way I fit in with LLNL's national security missions is that I develop software for the weapons program. So the software that we write gets used to ensure that the US nuclear stockpile is safe, secure, and reliable.
As a code developer, I support users with some of the issues they may have with running our codes. And I also develop methods that could be used for future machines that we may procure. It's awesome to think that those steps that I take just every day or every hour contribute to this global effort of users keeping the nation safer, or even the world safer, such as our asteroid mitigation program.
I'm currently a computational physicist working on the Teton thermal radiative transfer code. So being able to help with that code, maintain it, and like engaging with the users and designers who use it every day, it's really rewarding being able to help them finish, you know, their needs.
I ensure that the supercomputers we build are capable of running the simulations that we need to run to certify the stockpile. To me, this means that I contribute to the peace and security of my community.
I see my work reflected in these very important national security reports, and it's hugely satisfying.
I'm excited about how architectures are continuing to change. I think that's really exciting work because it means that we constantly have to be rethinking the ways that we've done things in our software and the algorithms that we tend to use.
Computing power is getting so great that there's a lot of physics that we could never do before, and it's really unlocking entire areas of simulated physics that were not available to us even 5 years ago.
AI is becoming a bigger thing. We're going to get bigger and bigger computers, but one of the main things that excites me as a scientist here at the lab is that there's so many possibilities for what can happen, and you know, we just don't know what the future will look like, even 10 years from now. You know, we don't know what the state of the art will be, or you know, what the pressing needs will be.
The thing that's really gotten me excited over the past couple of years is we have these giant GPU-based machines that just blow the door open to the kinds of simulations we can do. Specifically, we now have the ability to not only do 3D simulations, you know, that's a couple years ago that was the new hotness. Now what we can do is say, hey, let's couple in machine learning, let's couple in uncertainty quantification, let's couple in design optimization on these big complex 3D models. And we're just getting to where that's actually tractable thanks to these new supercomputers.
Nearly everything that I do for my job is actually towards the goal of eventually running our codes on the exascale computers that are going to be the next step.
I'm pretty excited about El Capitan coming within the next couple of years. So that's going to be an exascale machine. And people have been talking about exascale architecture since before I was a grad student for many years. And now I get to be at an institution where we get one of the exascale machines right off the bat. And even now, it's just cool to be in the planning phase and think about what methodologies and what algorithms are going to work best to run on our future exascale architectures.
We have access to development machines that are by themselves some of the biggest computers in the world.
We're getting kind of the bleeding edge technology from different hardware vendors. You know, in recent years, we're working a lot with GPUs. That trend's gonna continue in the future.
Literally, top three largest supercomputers in the world at any point in time.
It's interesting working on physics codes at Livermore because the teams are inherently interdisciplinary. For instance, the team that I work on is a combination of computer scientists, mathematicians, and nuclear engineers.
Physicists, chemists, applied mathematicians, various kinds of engineers, and we all have kind of slightly different ways of thinking about and tackling problems based on our different training. And so it's It's quite insightful to see how someone from a kind of different background tries to address a similar problem to what I'm thinking about. And so I learn from that kind of out-of-box thinking from my point of view, and I think I do the same thing with them. So we're constantly growing and learning from each other.
I like everything I'm learning from this experience. It's very rewarding to be learning about all these different sciences from the top researchers in those disciplines.
When I got here, I think the biggest surprise I had was it's a fairly diverse community of people from all kinds of backgrounds and beliefs.
I am treated as an expert in my field, and my management trusts my ability to determine what needs to be worked on.
I decided to convert to becoming permanent staff because of the amazing resources we have at the laboratory and the access of computing that I don't think you can really get at any other institution. And I wish I could go back in time and tell myself that I made the right decision. So it panned out way more than I expected it would.
Yeah, LLNL is different from what I imagined just because of all the different research opportunities that I encounter here. You know, I hear about all the different things that go on as an outsider even before coming here, but just being here and actually experiencing that and seeing all the different multidisciplinary teams coming together, it's actually quite amazing to see. And it's a really big reason of why I like coming to work every day.
So coming into the lab, I was afraid that I just couldn't cut it, that these are some of the brightest people in the entire country. But the thing that I missed was, because it's so interdisciplinary and collaborative, people really want to see each other succeed. So I had a great experience of learning from others. I was able to teach others some of my expertise, and it's the collaborative nature quelled those fears quite a bit. I love working at the lab. I wouldn't get to do this anywhere else.